Lab12, BGP Exploration and Attack Lab. This is the last lab for our semester. We are only required to complete task file. BGP Prefix Attack. This task is independent from the previous four tasks. You can find examples in this book chapter. Okay, first let's set up the lab environment. Seed internet emulator. Or follow the similar steps we did before. We have lots of containers need to build, so it will take some time. timing. It took me 12 minutes on my computer, 13 minutes. Yours may be different, just be patient. And also we need to remember we run inside output folder before we run inside the lab setup folder. For the last lab, we run inside the output folder. Now we can bring up all the containers. DC up. please be patient. Bring up also takes time. 6 minutes passed. Let's open a new tab. Okay, we still need to wait. looks like my Docker stuck. Okay, let's close these containers and restart it. Let's press Ctrl C to stop this site. Let's bring it up again. this time all the containers are fully brought up. You can see we have lots of containers. When you see something like this, it means all your containers are brought up and it's ready. It took me almost half an hour. Okay, now let's open the map. This is the internet we are working on. You can press you can scroll your button on your mouse to zoom in and zoom out. And click the router, the circle is a router. Square block is a network, the store is an internet exchange. So you can see the information. It is an ID name X101 and its prefix. Choose this hexagon in the host IP address. ASN, the autonomous system number, and you can launch a console here. There's a network. Okay, this is the internet. Yeah, the convention used in the emulator, ASN229 for large transit ASes, for example, the national backbone, 10 to 19 smaller transit ASes, 149 for the internet exchanges, 150, 199 for stop ASes. And the network prefixes and IP addresses. Here, for autonomous system N, is the first network prefix is 10.N.0.0.24.0. And the next one come to 1, 10.N.1.0. In each network address 202.255 or for routers or hosts, their IP addresses start from 71. For example, in AS145, the router did not write. And where 10.155.071 is a host. Usually, this is for broadcast. 254 would be right for BGP router. Now let's go to a task file. Here you can see an explanation about these tasks. The high level knowledge on BGP should be sufficient for task file. We will only do a task file. It's related to security. we can skip task 1 to 4. And this task file does not depend on the earlier tasks, so we jump to a task file right away. To get an example or task file, as the set here, read section 12. Or this chapter 27, the last chapter here, BGP hijacking attack. We will use information from this section. In this task file A, launch the prefix hijacking attack from AS161 to the attacker. Our goal is to hijack the IP prefix owned by AS154, the target. If the attack is successful, all the packets going to AS154 will be rerouted to the attacker autonomous system 161, where the IP packets will be dropped. Essentially, we are black holing AS154. Okay, where do we announce the prefix? We will use static protocol. So please read this section carefully by yourself. This AC section 3 was a tutorial for detailed explanation of the static protocol. Here we will use this one. And the prefix owned by AS154. So what's that prefix? Can in the search box type 154, press enter. Here is 154. See, they are highlighted. This is the prefix of AS154 as a BGP router. Called AS154. It contains two hosts. Before we launch the attack, we should be able to access these two hosts. And you see this BGP router of the AS154. It paired with AS2, AS4, AS11. Here you can see the AS2, AS4, then find here AS4, AS11. Here is the AS11. The routers. They are put together at this internet exchange at Chicago 102. Now this the prefix we are going to attack is this one, 10.154.0.0.24. Before we attack it, we should be able to access these two hosts. Let's have a look. For example, let's ping from this 155. We ping 154 host 0 from this one file host 0, but wait a moment, we didn't see this one, we didn't see it paired with this one file, so it, so we may not be able to pin it. We know, let's have a try. Here, when you check this one, it paired with your S2S4, right? So S2S4, the transit autonomous system. So let's have a try. Launch the console. What is a 1.55 host 71, host 0. Launch a console. We pin host 0 in AS154. And you see it's reachable. And we can see it vividly. ICMP, show it here. Well, you can see it go from host 0 to the BGP router through this AS2, then come to this AS154. Then come to this host 0. Okay, before we launch the attack, we are able to access AS154. The console, control C to stop it. Here, minimize, maximize, close. Let's just minimize. We'll use it later. Now we are going to launch the prefix hijacking attack by create a static protocol in the attack machine. The attack machine 161. Suddenly you can search it in the search box. 151, 180, 171. I would like to browse this network here. You see 160. We are asked to launch attack 161. Here is 161. To attack this 154. We can also open host 0 161, launch console to see whether we can access 154. Can see we are able to access it. Okay, now everything looks good. 161, control C, stop it, minimize. You can access the console here now. 155 host 0 161. The web service still is a server. Now to announce the attack, we need to go inside the router, the BGP router, launch the console, BGP router 161. Here it is. So we can check that boot configuration file. This configuration file. You can see it appears with S3. For the static, we didn't see any static loads here. Now, to announce the IP prefix, here it is. How do we do it? We use this example. Copy this one. Let's open editor. Okay, now you see when we copy from the PDF file, we messed up. Okay, here it is. You may double check to see anything missing. See, there is an error. Now we also need to we are going to attack one file form. Okay, this is what we need. Now, how do we put into this loader? If you are familiar with the VI, you may go ahead and use it. I would like to show you use GEditor. Then we need to copy back and forth to copy that configuration file. We make their task file cd task file. We copy the configuration file from the router here. Pay attention, 161.0. This file, then open it in GEditor. Now we can copy the static block. Let's paste here at the bottom. We paste here, Ctrl S, save it, then we need to copy it back. Back to the application. I check in this map. Just show it again. Then you see this static hijacks. Now we need to reconfigure, reload the configure. Dot C configure. Alright, reconfigured. Now let's see what we need to check. Here we didn't see a detailed expiration. So detailed expiration, go to this section. After that, you can we may go to any other loaders, for example, AS170, to see the route goes to the 150 file. Here it uses 164. We use a 154. We can go to a router and show the route to see it will be rerouted to the attacker 161. So let's have a check. In the map, we need bird shell route R to the victim prefix. Got another router 160. So then you may use any other router, let's say. Because I'm not sure whether everything is configured right. So let's use 161. The router launch console. We use a bird C shell root or to the victim prefix 154. Oops. You see it goes for 11 and 1.54. This route announced by the AS 154. Now we want to show the attacker's advertisement. Show route or 24.025. Now you see it's reloaded to 161 from this AS pass, right? Reloaded to 161 for the first half of the address space. Now the second half of the address space 128. Also reloaded 161. Now, if we ping from 155, before we launch the attack, 155 is able to access it, right? Now, this time we ping the host inside 154. Press enter. You see it's rerouted to the 161. At 161, that is dropped. 16155, and you see you get no reply. It's dropped in black hole. We didn't get a reply here. Now let's gonna see stop it. We sent out set 8 packets, received 0, 100% packet loss. So this 154 is hijacked by 161, and we are not able to access the autonomous system 154. Here you can also check the nodes in the kernel table, in the kernel routing table. For example, we can check that on a machine, on this 150 file. Here, when you check on a router, which router we are going to let 171, this router. The victim 154. Here you see this one and this one with 25 bits for the network ID. These two are the announcement from the attacker. This one is from 154 to the authoritative one, however, it's hijacked by the other two. Data on another machine to check the root. Here you see that we will go to 10.105.0.11, and we can go to that place, go to that router to see where it will go. Currently on 171, you see the router, it will come to this one, this router. Now let's go to that router. Set it like this. Here it is. Then launch console. Grep 10.154. Now you will go to here you see something different, right? For the previous one, you will go to this router button. Now, for the other two, you go to this router. Let's go ahead, go to the router. Okay, what it is? I didn't see highlight. 0.3x file. Here, x file. 0.3. Oops, I don't know why it cannot be highlighted. Here, you will come to this loader. Okay, now we check it. Console, launcher console. It does not let me launch your console. Okay, from there it will go to maybe go to this one and go to the attack machine here. You can see a root. Just follow this to the follow this route. Next one, and so on. .1.5.0.3 is this one. Okay, another way to load this console. Here, this ID. I don't know where this ID is, the doc ID or not. Change it to a hand. Now, let's show it. .1.5.4. Now it'll come to this place. This loader. 10.3.2.254. Is this one. Right here, 10.3.2.254. So this router, it will pair with this 161. So this is a full route, the hijacking route. So move your mouse. After you change it to a hand, click it. The location may not right. You see a little bit above the launch console. .1.5.4. Did you see it? It'll come to this attacker router. Okay, that's it. Now, come to this part. Here's the map. We can also show the destination. Okay, we can have a try. Show the destination. SMP. Destination 154.0.71. ping from another machine. One file file. We see it before. It's a hijacked 161 and dropped into a black hole. Can you see stop it? So the packet all related to 161 but are dropped over there. Now fighting back. We just complete task file point A. Now file point B. Fighting back. Fighting back by itself. And the file point C, the problem will be fixed at autonomous system 3, since autonomous system 3 is the service provider here, the upstream service provider for AS161. You can see this task file is almost an identical replication of this section, just use different autonomous systems, so we can follow this exactly. Now to fight back, those are bad attackers. We need to for each year the announcement, we will announce two for each of them, right? Here 25 26 26, one more bit 0 and 1 to cover the whole space of this one, and the other two cover the whole IP address spaces of this one. So inside one file 4, we need this one. Copy it. Now go to the untitled document, paste here. Here we have parentheses. This one. We need to change this 164 to the victim machine 154. The victim autonomous system. Okay, this is it. That's it. Now we also need to copy this one into the build file. Fill the router 154. So maybe we'd better close this one and just put it there. Go to our map. So 154 router. We didn't open it yet here. 154, the BGP router. Launch a console. You check the configuration file. Here it is. It appeared with AS11, AS4, AS2. Okay, that's it. Now we want to copy this one. Pay attention here. This ID, it is this docker ID. So you can just copy from here. We need to copy. Oops, now this time we already have a bird.conf here. So we can change name bird.conf to bird161, the attacker. Right. Now we use doc copy. Autonomous system. Quite a bird 154. Okay, here bird 154.conf. Now we use gEditor to open it. Again, we will put it at the end. Now this bird does not exist, just close it. Close without saving. The bird 154, we want to copy. So, fighting back, put it at the end. Ctrl V, Ctrl S, save it. Okay, it's saved. Now we copy it back. One file four. Copy, paste. Okay, it's a copy back. Double check it. 154 here, the router. We can show its contents again. You see it's a copy here. You need to reload the configure. Let's see configure. Okay, it's reconfigured. After the reconfiguration, wait a moment. Then you can go to other routers to check the root. Now you see the feedback. This one and this one. The feedback. This one, and this one, they fed back this one. Okay, now let's see. whether we can access that host from the 155 as we did it before. Do you see it? It get a reply, and you can see from that map. Okay, the feedback succeeded. Gonna see, stop it. I did the feedback. We already checked the feedback. You may also know here filtering out spoofed advertisement can use this one. This one is used by the service provider. Yeah, by the service provider. As they explain here, the service provider is AS3. Now we complete the task file dot B, not the one dot C, fixing the problem at AS3, right? The operator AS3 outreached. Now AS3 does not cut period with AS161. So the AS161 can still reach the internet. As the only service provider for the attacker. However, AS3 must stop the propagation of the fake announcement from the attacker. So it can use the filtering method. Here, this is the filtering method. Removing the fake notes from its own announcement, doing the own peers. Okay, let's do it. But before we do task file.c, we will disable the fighting back in file.b. Otherwise, we don't know which is which. Right? So we will go back to file.b to disable it. There is a quick way. Here, one file 4, we just comment out this fighting back. Okay, did comment out the whole block. Save it. Instead, we copy back. Here, 154. Press enter. Double check. In 154 router 0. First, we show you the configuration file content. Right, see, commented out. Then we need to reconfigure. Okay, it's reconfigured. You can double check at another router 171 to see those fighting back disappeared. Yeah, the previous, right, we see the fighting back. Now we check it again. You see that the fighting back disappeared. The 26, that disappeared. So, which means in this case, there is no fighting back. So, which means AS154 is hijacked by 161. You can double check from a pin here. Pin from 155. And it's no feedback, no response. Right, it's hijacked by 161. We restored the attack the scenario. Can you see stop it? Now this time is the responsibility of the service provider role this 161. The service provider is AS3 here. ASN3 the router. It appeared with 161 at the internet exchange 103. AS3. You need to filter out fake announcement. Just follow this one. Then you can copy this sentence. But again, we need to open it first. Launch your console. Okay, move it carefully. What is it opened here? There's a build file, IBGP123. For all this stuff, you can practice in task 1-4 if you want to have a practice. All those tasks, you can find a corresponding example in this last chapter or the tutorial. Now we want to copy this one, copy the build file, minimize it. We want to know this one is the ID, right? The docker ID, container ID, and copy it. We copy from the container. The AS3 router. And a quiet build 3. Open it in the editor. Now this build 3, we need to find 161, the customer URL. This AS3, that is the customer. What do we need to add? Here, in the import field, add before accept. I may compare this one with the contents here. Right? And compare them one by one. Make sure it's 161. There's an attacker here, the table, TPGP import field. We want to add the statements, the filtering statements here. What order does it see them identical? The syntax, except the IP address, right? Because here it uses a different autonomous system. Copy this one. Paste here. Now, we also need to change. The victim is 154. And 154. So, for those announcements from 161, if not even this one, then reject it. Okay, wait a moment. Is this right? Import from 161. The announcement for 161. The net. We only accept the net from 161. So any other announcement from 161, they would be fake. So here it would be 161. If net is not 161, then we reject them. So it cannot announce fake announcement for others. So we can check this statement here. Right, 150. Which means it can only announce its own IP prefix. There is a 161. Counter S. It's saved. Now we copy back. To the container. Bird 3. Paste here. Okay, double check. Go to the router. AS3 here. Route 103. You see the also node 105 is that one, and the 103 is the service provider for this 161, the AS161, not that one. So it's a 103. Right, you see that go up, find that 162, 161, you'll see that the statement we add here. Anytime you modify the configuration file, we need to reload it. Proceed, configure. Okay, it's reconfigured. If you have error, typo, something inside your configuration file, it will show up here. If there's no error, you will see it says reconfigured. Okay, now it's reconfigured. We can check those as announcement at another 171 to see whether those hijacking, right? To the hijack announcement, they will disappear. It disappeared. The 24 and that disappeared. Now the filtering is succeeding. We should be able to excise the one or restored the Excel on this 154. We pinned from 155, right? Here, 155 host 0 pinned. See, we get a reply, and on the map, see it also. But on the map, we don't know whether we have reply, right? So you need to check here. We see reply here. So Ctrl C, stop it. Zero packet loss. So the second way is the service provider to stop it's a cyber autonomous system announce fake announcement. So here is a single home AS, this 161. It only paired with this. Right? Check here. It only paired with AS3, the ASP for this AS161. If it's not homed, it would appear more than one service provider, then all the service provider need to filter the fake announcement from this stop AS. Okay, we completed all the tasks. Now, how do we stop these things? First, close this text editor. I would like to save it as a template for you. Close this one. Close the browser. Here to run DC DOM in the output folder. DC DOM to bring down all the containers. There is an error. It has active endpoint. So what's that active endpoint? Here you see our exceeded. I didn't see where I opened, so I have an active endpoint anyway. Everything is they were closed. Ctrl D. Okay, that's it.